Well, we've not changed on Huawei. We're not allowing Huawei into our country. We're not changed on that. We can do business for non-security things with Huawei.
Huawei was targeted by President Donald Trump with restrictions on the scale of murder. Due to the escalating trade war, the administration blocked Huawei back in 2020, effectively cutting off its ability to purchase American-made chips and forcing US companies to cut ties with Huawei. After both sides imposed tariffs on billions of dollars of each other's goods, the trade conflict between the world's two largest economies continued to escalate. China threatened to stop supplying rare earth minerals to the US and reportedly stopped buying US soybeans. In this video, we will be discussing how Donald Trump killed Huawei. Let's begin. Specifically, on August 17, 2020, US Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross announced any company seeking to sell chipsets to Huawei designed or fabricated with US tech must first obtain a license. Huawei's flagship products, its 5G equipment, and most significantly its smartphones, are powered by these chips. During the past few years, the company, once hard to pronounce, has grown into a household name in the United States. Next, there were US sanctions, criminal charges, trade restrictions, geopolitical threats, and special designations from the government to isolate the company and its next-generation 5G equipment from Western telecom networks. Moreover, the US argued that Huawei, as a Chinese company, does not deserve a position of trust in Western networks because of the general fear that the Chinese Communist Party will bring pressure against its domestic companies. Huawei has acted as a company unworthy of trust over the last decade. Huawei is now prohibited from using its custom chipsets designed or manufactured using US technology. The restriction was only announced in May, on the first anniversary of Huawei's block listing. This latest move, which wasn't planned when Huawei was looking for third-party chipsets, has now cut off Huawei's Plan B. A new set of sanctions targeting Huawei has been launched following the initial silicon sanctions, which had a drastic impact on the Chinese company. It was no less than a havoc for Huawei. Not only has Trump used tariffs in his trade war with China, but he has also threatened to slap tariffs on Mexican imports if that country does not take action to control migration across the border. After Mexico and the US agreed on immigration issues, the US avoided the Mexican tariffs. Reng Zhenfei, who served as a tech specialist in the People's Liberation Army, founded Huawei, which has all the support it needs from the Communist Party of China. Huawei's rapid growth became a source of concern due to its ties with the CCP. Due to their omnipresence across the globe, especially in the US, they pose a threat at a time of escalating tensions between the two countries. They sell telecommunications equipment and consumer electronics, so they have access to a great deal of data. The Chinese government's strong support for Huawei has resulted in suspicion on President Trump's part. India phased out Chinese equipment from its telecom network. They asked their local telecom companies to avoid using Chinese equipment. The aftermath of the incident has a surprise twist. China showed silence at that moment. Within a week of the US administration issuing what some analysts have described as a death sentence, Huawei realized China would not be able to turn this situation around with a silver bullet. In a flare-up in the South China Sea or along the line of actual control with India, a US ally, Huawei could become a source of intelligence for the CCP. Since President Trump's latest round of sanctions against Huawei that left them reeling, other countries have been quietly phasing out the company as well. China has already attacked Canada massively in the past. Huawei is another potential threat, and Canada has handled it quietly while avoiding confrontation. A Chinese government spokesman disclosed that the Chinese government would continue to safeguard Chinese companies' legitimate rights and interests. The United States did not retaliate in any way against any Chinese firms operating in China. There was a notable lack of comments. The question, then, is why the US didn't think of this latest move sooner if it is on a mission to kill Huawei, as some reports have put it, for 15 years plus. Huawei remains banned from using custom chipsets designed or manufactured with the assistance of US tech in May 2020, a year after the Trump administration restricted Huawei's success to US components. Huawei admitted this could severely damage the company and reached for Plan B, reverting to standard chipsets that others could purchase. And then came the death blow from America. Huawei would be prohibited from using those standard chipsets as well. In effect, the company would be banned from purchasing the silicon necessary to power its consumer devices, cloud servers, and 5G networks. No industry player, including those in China, is willing to take that risk since Huawei needs a license to sell them. As a result, MediaTek, expecting huge sales from Huawei, applied for a permit to continue those supplies. Again, given how practical this last move has been, why didn't Trump go there earlier? He may have needed to test Beijing's resistance. China threatened to retaliate against US companies after the initial sanctions, but nothing was done. It is also possible that Trump was genuinely surprised that Huawei has thrived under the blacklist. Additionally, it is noteworthy that the United States took this action at this time. The preceding weekend, headlines focused on the expiration of the temporary general license, under which, among other things, Huawei phones that shipped with Google could still receive updates from the US company even when it was forbidden from licensing newer smartphones. Huawei assured Google phones would continue to operate as usual. Google did not comment. In the lead-up to the US moving against Huawei's silicon supply chain, Google was the most significant blow the administration had scored against Huawei's consumer business, the fastest-growing and most profitable part. Despite the blacklist, Huawei releases new flagship phones, including the Mate 30, the P40, and the impending Mate 40. But thanks to those sales in China, as well as multi-billion dollar 5G equipment contracts also secured at home, Huawei continues to grow revenues and profits, fueling its research and development machine. The US has been campaigning increasingly successfully to eject Huawei from 5G plans around the world. However, the consumer business appeared to be bulletproof. In May 2020, the critical question was whether Huawei had built up a large enough stockpile of chips to secure itself against the new US sanctions. In most cases, 12 to 24 months were thought to be adequate. Huawei did not have enough Kirin chips to support the Mate 40 launch on the smartphone front, perhaps not even for that. Assuming the company can survive until early next year, at least with third-party chips, it is reasonable to think it will proceed until then. There may have been a long wait for 5G equipment at that time. In an attempt to replace the Google software and services it has lost, Huawei told the market about its HMS alternative. Making HMS work is critical, as the company's UK consumer head told me last week just before the latest US sanctions were announced. Users hooked on Google knew it would not rebuild if it couldn't convince them to switch. The new US action has thrown that plan up in the air, and it's been undermined by the announcement that Huawei will no longer manufacture hardware. This assumes that Huawei can compete with Samsung and Apple and Xiaomi, Vivo and Oppo. The phone is at the heart of Huawei's consumer strategy, holding together its attempts at smart TV, PCs, autos, wearables, tablets, and smartwatches. If it cannot keep smartphone users, it will not sell the rest of its strategy. It is the consumer business that currently drives Huawei's profitability. With Huawei's consumer business facing a death sentence, its enterprise and 5G technology clients around the world are in trouble as well. Richard Yu confirmed Huawei to be using the custom Kirin chip for the first time with the Mate 40, the last of its kind. At that time, it appeared that the Mate 40 was more significant than the iPhone. It seemed that it would take a political or technical miracle for Huawei to have a chance this time around in the fickle world of consumer products. Well, that will be all from this video, folks. Thank you so much for watching, and we hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please consider subscribing to our channel. We'll see you with another one soon, so take care and goodbye.